It's up to you how many tracking variables you want to put in your game, and how often you would change their values during the story. A ChoiceScript game without variables could play like a choose-your-own-adventure book. For this example, however, I'm using two main variables to track progress. The player could prioritize skill improvement versus improvement in relationship with the NPC. At the turning point of the story, I make one of the choices only selectable if the player has prioritized relationship. Here is an instance where the player can feel the impact of their past choices. The ChoiceScript syntax *selectable_if is self-explanatory. Though be careful to always wrap the complete conditional check inside parentheses. Whenever you want to add a new tracking variable that persists from scene to scene, like what I'm doing at line 13, remember to go back to startup.txt and create it there. This variable can contain the value of either true or false. Think of it like a checkmark when it's set to true. At the ending of the story, I use a series of conditional checks, like I did in the ChoiceScript_stats file, to display the flavor text that's different for different player choices. Some text, such as the end, doesn't need to be inside an if code block, since it will be displayed to every player. The last thing to do before closing the scene file is to use a *ending to stop the game engine from trying to look for more scene files. *finish would work the same way if there is no other scene files listed under *scene_list in startup.txt, but *ending is more definitive. Feel free to ask questions about this specific game or ChoiceScript in general in the comments section. The forum on the Choice of Games website is also a great place to get advice and feedback about your game. Best of luck!